The largest gains from immigration come from the movement of individuals from low-wage countries to high-wage countries. To make this more concrete, compare the United States to the Caribbean nation of Haiti. Per capita income in Haiti is a bit over $1,000 a year. Per capita income in the United States is well over $40,000 a year. So when Haitians are able to migrate to the United States, generally their wages and their incomes rise. Let's say you take all the Haitians in either the United States or Haiti and look at those who are earning $10 a day or more. It turns out that 4/5 of that group of Haitians are actually living in the United States. To date, the best way of curing poverty in Haiti has been to allow Haitians to move to the United States, Canada, France, and other nations. Or let's look at Mexico and the United States. Using data from the year 2000, if we take a typical young Mexican male with 9 to 11 years of schooling, that individual will earn about $2.40 an hour in Mexico. That same individual in the United States will tend to earn $8.70 an hour. If you add that all up across the course of a year with a full-time job, there is a gain of more than $10,000 when that individual moves to the United States. Another study tracked particular legal immigrants from Mexico to the United States, and it found there was a gain of almost $16,000 a year in terms of higher income after migration. A Guatemalan who moves to the United States will see his wages go up by a factor of sixfold, and for a Kenyan, wages on average go up by a factor of sevenfold. Of course, this is not just about the United States. In Oceania, many individuals from the island nation of Tonga migrate to New Zealand. There is a visa lottery where winners are selected randomly. Those individuals who are able to leave Tonga and migrate to New Zealand end up having wages which are 263% higher simply because they are living in New Zealand. A study by the World Bank showed that if the 30 wealthiest OECD nations were willing to expand the size of their labor forces by 3%, the gains to the migrants would be in the order of $300 billion in the form of higher wages. When it comes to anti-poverty recipes, there's really just one which we know works for sure, and that is immigration to wealthier countries. To read more on this topic, there's an excellent article by Michael Clemens, Economics and Immigration. There's the survey article by Gordon Hansen on many aspects of migration, and also look at the writings of Lant Pritchett, which you can find through Google.